Today we will continue with our chapter 3 of Great Expectation. So let's get started. Pip decides to educate himself. When I reached home, my sister and Pumblepook were very curious to know all about Miss Havisham and asked a number of questions. I knew that if I described Miss Havisham as my eyes had seen it, I would not be understood. So I made up stories of the wonderful time I spent with Miss Havisham and Astilla. A little later, Joe came in. Now I could not lie further and left the room. I spent the evening with Joe at the forge. He asked me, "I hope you had a great time." I replied, "I lied to Miss Joe and Pumblecook. I had a horrible time at Miss Havisham's." I then told Joe about Astilla and said, "She finds me extremely common and seems to hate me for my poor clothes and rough hands." I was most hurt by her rebukes than anything else. Joe was annoyed with the fact that I had lied earlier, but forgive me later. When I went up to my little room and said my prayers, my young mind was in a disturbed and unthankful state. Yet it was a memorable day, as it had changed my life forever. The next day, when I woke up, I realized that the best step I could take towards making myself uncommon was to get out of Biddy everything she knew. In pursuance of this luminous conception, I requested Biddy when I went to Mr. Whoops's aunt's at night that I had a particular reason for wishing to get on in life and that I should feel very much obliged to her if she would impart all her learning to me. Biddy, who was the most obliging of girls, said immediately that she would and indeed began to carry out her promise within 5 minutes. I was delighted. While going home, I had to meet Joe at the village inn, where he went to smoke his pipe and have a drink at times. I reached the place and saw that Joe was smoking his pipe with Mr. Whoopsel and a stranger. Joe greeted me as usual with, "Hello, Pip, old chap," and the moment he said that, the stranger turned his head and looked at me. He seemed to recognize me, but I could not recall meeting him. I quietly went and sat next to Joe. Mr. Whoopsel and Joe were busy talking, but the strange man kept looking at me. After a while, he ordered rum and stirred his drink not with a spoon that was brought to him, but with a file. I instantly knew that it was Joe's file and this man was my convict. I sat gazing at him spellbound. After a while, Joe got up and took me by the hand. "Stop half a moment, Mr. Gregory," said the stranger. "I think I have got a bright new shilling somewhere in my pocket, and if I have, the boy shall have it." He took it out from a handful of small change, folded it in a crumpled piece of paper, and gave it to me. "Yours," said he. "Mind it, your very own." I thanked him, staring at him far beyond the bounds of good manners and holding tight to Joe. He wished Joe good night and we walked out. When we returned home, I opened the crumpled paper to my great surprise. The crumpled paper actually held 2 notes of £1. I gave them to Joe as it was a lot of money and he ran to the inn to return them to the stranger, but he was nowhere to be found. So my sister finally kept the notes in the cupboard. I went to sleep quite perturbed that night and was continuously haunted by the file and the stranger in my dreams. Now we will summarize chapter 3. On his return from Miss Havisham's house, Pip lies to his sister and Pumblecook that he had a good time then. But Pip tells Joe the truth and says Estella was rude because Pip had poor clothes and rough hands. That night, Pip had a disturbed sleep. Next day, he decided to educate himself and took help of Biddy. On his way back home, he stopped by Village Inn and met Joe, Mr. Whoopser, and a stranger. The stranger turned out to be the convict and he gave him £2. Pip gave it to Joe, who gave it to Mr. Joe, who kept it in cupboard. That night, Pip was haunted by stranger and his dreams. Now we will do the difficult word meaning of the difficult words. As you can see, here are some of the difficult words of chapter 3. Curious, eager to know or learn something. Rebuke, express disapproval. Disturbed, to unsettle, to disarrange, to interrupt. Pursues, the action of trying to achieve something. Obliged, be grateful or indebted. Impart, make known, bestow a quality. Recall, remember, officially order someone to return to a place. Instantly, immediately. Spellbound, fascinate, hold, complete, attends. Staring, look fixedly at someone or something. Perturbed, upset, anxious. Haunted, visited by ghosts showing signs of mental anguish. Thank you.